Now the next method to separate a solid liquid mixture is crystallization. So what is crystallization? It is a process in which slow evaporation of a solution containing more of the solid component is done. So here we have a mixture which contain the solid in large amount and will carry out the process of evaporation at a very slow rate. Like the solution of pure sugar, when we want to obtain pure sugar from its solution in water, we will use this process of crystallization. So first of all, the sugar solution is heated at a very high speed, okay? But when we have water in very less amount, that time we'll start cooling it, and after cooling it will separate out in the form of crystals. So what are crystals? These are the solid particles which have definite shape and size, and they are very shiny, like the sugar particles, okay? They are cubical and they are shiny also. Now the next technique is distillation. So what is distillation? It is a process of converting a liquid into vapor by heating and the subsequent condensation of the vapor back into the liquid. So here both the process will take place. First of all, we'll change the liquid into vapor by heating it, and after that we'll carry out the process of condensation by which we can get the liquid back. Okay, so this method is used when both the solid and liquid can be recovered. Okay, so first of all, the solution is heated and the liquid evaporate in the form of vapor, and after that it will pass through the condenser and we'll get it back in the form of pure liquid, and that is known as distillate. And the solid is left behind in the distilling flask. So this is the process of distillation. Here we have distillation flask in which we carry out the process of distillation. It is connected to the Liebig condenser, and here we have Bunsen burner, salt solution we have. Okay, so first of all, we'll carry out the process in which we'll start heating this mixture, and after that it will convert in the form of vapor. Then after that we'll carry out the process of condensation. By this condenser we'll get the liquid back again, okay, and the solid is left behind in the distilling flask. Now see, the tap water is the best example because it contains some of the dissolved salt and it is purified by the process of distillation, and after that the pure water will obtain, and that is known as distilled water. Now the last technique to separate solid liquid mixture is centrifugation. So what is centrifugation? It is the method of separating solids from liquid where the mixture is homogeneous. Okay, so here the mixture is homogeneous, and this is also known as churner. An apparatus called centrifuge is used for this purpose. So the instrument or the apparatus which is used for this purpose is known as centrifuge. So the mixture is placed in the centrifuge tube and rotated at a high speed. Okay, and due to that the heavy solid particles will move towards the bottom. It means the solid particles, due to their high density, they will settle down at the bottom, and the light particle which have less density, they will float on the surface of liquid, and due to this the separation will take place due to the difference in the density. The best example is cream. Cream is separated from the milk by this process. At home we use mixers or traditional churners to separate cream from milk. So this process is used even now in dairies. It is also used nowadays also in washing machine. This principle is used to squeeze out water from wet cloth. So the washing machine also work on this principle of centrifugation. So the techniques to separate solid liquid mixture is over now.